Kara quickly learnt what was expected of him on the dark railway, and soon won the admiration of the other engines. He mainly worked on the Soma branch line, taking full ballast wagons to the junction and bringing the empty one back. Lino appreciates this, as he is now in charge of all of the Soma branch passenger trains. However, he sometimes has to venture out onto the rest of the line, and one evening he found himself at Mirkum, where he had gained a lot of sympathy and respect from the other engines, due to the sad story of his brother and of his early withdrawal from British Rail. "This is absolutely appalling! What are British Rail playing at? Withdrawing a perfectly healthy, honest and hard-working diesel locomotive so early in his life! Don't forget that they did the same to the standard class in 2, Eustace. Some of them, such as Brian's brothers and sisters, only had a working life of about 14 years. Oh, don't bring up my siblings. The less spoken of them, the better. That's all very well, 257, but our young friend here was only in service for 6 years. 6 years! Think of that!
It really is an amazing story of survival. It's really lucky you were down this way at the time, Kammer.
I'm amazed at my luck, actually. Lino was telling me that he is in exactly the same situation as me when he arrived. British Rail really need to sort out their priorities. The other engines agreed, and soon they began to nod off for the night. The next morning, as the engine prepared for work, Mr. Dark arrived and spoke to Kammer.
"Good morning, Kammer. I hope you're settling in well."
"Yes, sir. I'm really enjoying myself, actually, for the first time in a long while."
"That's good to hear. Now, I know it's a bit of a bother, and I'm sure you're keen to get back to your own part of the line, but would you please run a cattle train from Woolchurch to the junction for me?"
Kammer hesitated for a moment. He had so far avoided mentioning to anybody that he was frightened of animals, and I'm afraid to say that he was very embarrassed about it. Nevertheless, he didn't want Mr. Dart to think poorly of him so early on in his new career.
Yes, sir." "That's a good engine. Hurry along now. And Dave, if I see you do that again, you will be very sorry indeed."
So Kammer rolled away to Woolchurch to pick up the train. When he arrived, he saw Brian muttering to himself in his dedicated banker's siding. "These figures don't add up at all. How can 257 be using 20% more coal than Eustace? It just doesn't make sense." Kammer decided not to disturb him, and headed over into the yard, where a train of empty cattle wagons stood. He buffed up to them whilst the shunter connected him up. His driver, realising that they may be there for a little while, decided to head over to the station and chat up the pretty young lady he had spotted when they arrived, leaving Kammer on his own. The farmer soon arrived with his cows. He brought them up to the cattle dock, where they shuffled about. Suddenly, there was a commotion nearby. Somebody was trying to pinch the farmer's new tractor. He hurried away, shouting, and completely forgot to close the gates of the cattle dock. The cows, hungry and curious, moved out of the dock and towards the tracks. Kammer was already feeling unnerved by the constant mooing, and was completely taken by surprise when he saw a group of cows venturing towards him. He was terrified as they came closer, and began to shake with fear. He tried to call for his driver, but the driver was too busy talking to the girl on the platform to pay him any attention.
"Oh dear! Oh God, help me, please, someone, please! Oh God, help! Ah, oh, help!
With a stroke of luck, Colin suddenly arrived with a short goods train. Hearing Kammer's cries, he abandoned his own train at the yard entrance and hurried over.
"It's all right, Kammer. They're only cows. Oh, please. Oh, please, get them away from me, please. Oh, God."
Colin blasted his whistle, but the cows didn't move. They didn't move until he opened his cylinder cocks and blew steam at them. By this time, the farmer had returned after seeing off the would-be thieves, and horrified, quickly set around to rounding up the cows, with some help from Colin's crew and the shunter.
"What's wrong, Kammer? Don't you like cows?"
I don't like animals, full stop. A while ago, I was working near a farm, and a goat came out of nowhere and slammed into me several times, hitting me with its horns, damaged my buffer beam. I've not liked animals ever since. Oh, I'm so embarrassed."
Colin laughed.
"Ha! Being frightened of something isn't anything to be ashamed of. We can't help our fears, and for something like that to happen to you, I'm not surprised that you don't like them.
I don't like thunder. It scares the ashes out of me."
Really?
Yeah.
Well, thank you, Colin, for getting rid of the cows.
Oh, it's all right. I suppose you'll want me to move my wagon so you can leave?
Oh, yes, please.
Cameron left Wolmchurch soon afterwards, still feeling very shaken by his encounter with the cows.